Beat
103. Hello, Sarah. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you, Jodie. How are you?
Yes, very good, thank you. Thanks for joining us. Today, we are talking about Dubai.
We are. One of my favourite places in the world.
Tell us a little bit about Dubai.
Dubai used to be, in the bygone days, a small fishing village in the Arabian Gulf. Now, it's one of the most cosmopolitan cities in the world. It's one of the 7 emirates that make up the UAE, the United Arab Emirates. And it's home to nearly 200 nationalities. People have a misconception about Dubai, thinking it's quite restricted and you can't do an awful lot of things while you're there. Nothing really could be further from the truth. Getting to Dubai is really easy. So you've got Manchester, Birmingham, Glasgow and Gatwick and Heathrow, all service Emirates, which is the national carrier, flying direct into Dubai. Flying time is approximately 8 hours, depending where you're flying from. Your weather in Dubai, it's absolutely glorious. The winters last from October to May, with warm temperatures from 20 to 35 Celsius. The summer lasts from June to September, and that's when that thing called air conditioning you will be really grateful for, because the temperatures go from the mid-40s right up to 110 Fahrenheit. It gets really, really hot. So a lot of people who travel to Dubai will tend to go in our winter where it's a bit more bearable.
Okay, so what are the top attractions in Dubai?
Top attractions in Dubai, there's so many, apart from the obvious, which is that beautiful beach and the Gulf. You've got the Burj Khalifa, which is the tallest building. You've got Dubai Parks and Resorts, which is a theme park with over 100 attractions. So it's got different parks, imagine Disney, but not. We've got Motion Gate, which is Hollywood-inspired theme park. So things like DreamWorks, Lionsgate, Columbia Pictures. Bollywood celebrates the Indian film market. You've got a Legoland there as well. Suited for kids from 2 to 12. Over 40 rides. There's also a water park. And then you've got Riverland, is an entertainment and dining boulevard. As well as all of that, you've got Ski Dubai, where you can actually ski in real snow, which doesn't sound right in your head because you go into somewhere that's so, so hot, but they actually make the real snow. It's not fake. It's done every night and then it's there in the morning. You've got the water parks. You've got Atlantis Adventure. You can swim with the dolphins. You've got Wild Wadi Adventure Park. You've got all the shopping malls. You've got the souk, where you can do your bartering. Best thing to barter for is gold and leather as well. And you've got the Dubai Fountain, got to mention that one. Every 30 minutes it comes to life from 6 p.m. It's colourful illuminated jets, weighing time to a range of medleys. So it could be anything from Michael Jackson's Thriller to a bit of opera. And there are videos of it actually doing it on YouTube and it's amazing.
What are the updates for 2021, obviously, with the current climate?
Yeah, it's still popular. Obviously, the change really since I've done this guide is it was on the safe corridor list. Literally within 24 hours of me doing this guide, it's now gone off the safe corridor list. So at the moment, it's going to be a bit hard to get to. At some point, it will go back on the safe corridor list. You've got Sofitel Dubai hotels. You've got 5 or 6 other hotels all being launched this year, whether it's on the Palm, which is just off Jumeirah Beach, the main beach, or there's some in the city as well. There's some near the creek, which is the old part of Dubai. Attractions, you've got Museum of the Future, that's currently under construction. It's going to be a 6-story built using robot-made pieces depicting an Arabic calligraphy. So it's going to be something quite special. The view at the Palm, that's going to open. Legoland Hotel are planning to have an opening as well. That'll be the first Lego-themed hotel this year. Lego-themed rooms, a Lego castle play area and candy-coloured exterior. And that will be within the Dubai Parks and Resorts.
Brilliant. Do you have any offers for us?
I do. Got a cracking one, actually. Really good offer. This is a New Year special that came out, as the name would suggest, of days ago, but obviously still there. 5-star Dubai half board, 7 nights, £999 per person, and it's based on the iconic Jumeirah Beach, which is right on Jumeirah, next to Wild Wadi Water Park. Kids love it. very much a family orientated hotel. Unlimited access to that water park. You also get your complimentary half board dining around, because there's different hotels in this chain because it's part of Jumeirah. You can go to the other hotels and have dinner or lunch there. Complimentary access to Sinbad Club Resort and complimentary Wi-Fi throughout the resort, and private transfers included, and it's flying with Emirates, so it's direct.
There is quite a big guide to Dubai, isn't there, on your Facebook page?
There certainly is. There's a huge guide to Dubai. So you're looking for Facebook and you are looking for the Beat 103 Travel Show, and it will be on there straight after this. 16 pages with tons more information, including all those hotels that are happening this year, and lots more information on the attractions and things as well.
Thank you very much, Sarah.
Beat 103.